the amount of effort and the amount of time that officials put into to perfecting their craft, I think, is something that maybe goes unrecognized.
We don't really have any days off. I'm up at 5:30 in the car on my way to work at 6, and I'm on the phone with another crew chief, Mark Cardonio. You know, we spend the hour as I drive into work talking about anything that could come up in a game.
You have a game here in Philadelphia.
Yep, 1 o'clock start.
And then immediately after.
Yep.
Can you take me through that travel?
So we'll wrap the game up. You know, it's about 2:20 to get a game done. So let's just say 3:30 for argument's sake. We're kind of wrapping up, and we got a 6:10 flight down to Georgia.
First quarter, we'll see what they give us. We'll bear down, we'll communicate. You know, we won't stop talking to the players throughout the whole game. And then the fourth quarter, hopefully we're in a spot then where we can really let them grind it out. And, you know, we earn our money when we get there. I think one of the things, too, that'll help us today and tomorrow is manage the little things, and then the big things won't be as problematic. And so I think that if we go that route, we'll be good.
I think it's just managing the temperature of the game, right? Knowing kind of when we're getting to that boiling point and...
Yeah, putting the lid back on and letting it start.
Back on. Yeah.
You got Philly good defensively, Philly good offensively. New England good defensively and good offensively. So good. they're gonna be pushing hard all night. So I think the big thing too, it's a 1 o'clock start. It's a little bit of unusual. So
very
like
unusual.
There's no time for us to kind of get the nerves off and the juice flowing. When 1 o'clock hits, we gotta be ready to go. So that's what I see.
No shifts off, right?
No shifts off.
No passengers.
Yep. No, everybody's active and everybody's part of it, and let's be successful.
We like to get the rink about 2.5 hours early, and we sit down and we have a real good meeting and chat amongst everyone that's on the crew. So the three on-field officials and the shot clock one off the field. We talk about, you know, what we've noticed as far as, you know, player tendencies, common issues, you know, positioning, how do we be in the best spot to make the right call. As a crew chief, I'm looking at, you know, what are the video angles that we'll have, you know, what are past issues, and how do we make sure that this game is going to go seamlessly.
We're all right. Let's check the face off. Luke, you can take a shot at the shot clock, make sure it goes. If you got a hit run on the game clock, I think that's fine too. I just want to make sure that they're working this week. Again, it's going to be so important that we line them up properly. Like, so important.
Yep.
Because the two of them are just going to be battling all night. Like, no doubt. Good. The boys want to start shooting, I guess. So let's go get changed up then and get some stretch. I got to go see a doctor with my foot. And we'll reconvene.
Beautiful.
Awesome.
It's a tough go sometimes when you get nicked up and your body's sore, and we're lucky that the NL has a great training staff on every team where you can get, you know, game day maintenance to make sure that you are you're ready to go, because it is truly a grind. You know, you finish the game, you hop on a flight, you're stiff, you get off, you're even more stiff, and then sleep and get up, and then you got to get the juice flowing again for another game.
I think it's a bone spur coming on or something. Yeah, and it's been coming on, like the pain's been coming on more and more here as I go.
No pain in the toes down here?
Nope.
I just want to loosen the tissue up a little bit. It's a little mobile.
And most of it is right
there. That was a 10.
Okay. Oh. Totally relax your foot here. Good job.
That was all you.
I have a pad to take a little.
And I'm going to come in and see you right after the game to get this on, because like you guys, we're all kind of boon and rally out here. So.
Lacrosse is a unique sport in that, you know, anybody that's involved is sort of consumed by the sport. Mm-hmm. And it's unique in that there's such great relationships amongst officials, coaches, and players. Mm-hmm. And I think that's one of the things that I find most compelling about the sport is that, you know, we have a tough job to do, and, you know, we have to administer the penalties and make tough calls, and sometimes it goes in a team's favor, sometimes it doesn't. But what's really unique is that when the dust settles, everybody is sort of very even keeled, and, you know, I get it, maybe I don't agree with it, but, you know, there's no animosity from one person to the other, and that's, you know, that's something that I find really unique about our sport. And, you know, I think if you asked any official, it's something that they would cherish about the game, too.
All right, boys. Pop them in there. Thanks.
Let's get it started real early. Push them, push them, push them. All right, let's go. Hey, bear down, eh? It's a team out here. We pick each other up. Let's, yep, everything goes. Set the pick, Callum! Good picks! Number nine. Go. You rode up high. Go. I know it did. It still got him. Did you not hear him screaming off the bench nonstop?
He just said Garrison, that's what he said.
No, he didn't. He kept going nonstop screaming. It's a clear penalty on Nardella.
Okay.
And then your bench goes loony.
Like, the entire of it. Is he cursing or anything? Or?
Oh, yeah, but that, Clarkie wasn't the one swearing. All I'm saying is it's a bench penalty.
Okay.
Everybody's screaming because they don't think it's a penalty.
Guy, five.
Nardella goes low, trips the guy without an ounce of devout.
He jumped out. He just jumped out.
Who
just jumped momentum out? Checked him.
No, your guy dove right in. Well, that's how I saw it. Good goal. We need nothing here. That's a good goal. We're in a deep, dark hole here, boys. It's a tough game.
Referees get in there to break it up. But O'Connor caught looking for the pass.
That was, eh? Turn South Lake. Luke, great job in there, man. Good job. Whew. It was like bookends.
Good job, man. Good job.
Yeah, well, that's what happens, right? When games get testy late, we gotta manage it. Oh, that was a jog, though. Those two teams are gritty.
You can tell from the opening faceoff.
So how long has this been bothering you for?
It's been kicking in the last couple of weeks here, real
last
bad.
Couple of weeks. Was there a specific injury regarding this, or just started out of the blue?
No, just started out of the blue. Like you can see, it's pretty.
Yeah. It's bigger than it was earlier.
Yeah. After you ran around today, right?
Yeah.
It was a lot smaller.
All right. Was this swollen like this after your last game that you roughed?
So the bumps really started to emerge the last couple of days.
Last couple of days. Yeah. How long have you had pain in the foot?
Since that bump started really forming. Right. So it's been this week. It's been kind of every day. It's a little bit worse.
A little worse.
Yeah.
3 weeks ago, was it normal?
Yeah.
All right. You didn't take a ball there, right?
Nope.
Maybe lay back for a second, please.
Oh. Okay.
I'm hanging in there. Oh. We done?
We're done.
Oh man, that was painful.
Where's the cat?
God, it's gone.
Yeah.
Just like that, eh?
You gotta keep faith, man.
You know, I want to continue to be the, you know, the best crew chief I can be. The goal is always to reduce the amount of errors that we make. Continue to support the development of other officials along the way. And you know, at the end of the day, when it comes time to hang it up, hopefully the league's in a better spot than it was before I got there. That's sort of how I'd ice the cake.